This plant, we are treating fridges, let's say household fridges, but also the big professionals. Uh-huh. We also treat big white, we call it, it's washing machines, dishwashers. And we do basically all here. So we receive them here, we take care of these, let's say, hazardous materials. We suck out the cooling agents, which in the past was freon. Still, some freon materials are received. We take care of the proper treatment of these materials, and basically the product that leaves this facility are aluminium, which we can sell, copper, plastic, and the plastic is treated at one of our subsidiaries somewhere in the Netherlands.
So what does the circular economy really mean for Coolrec?
Coolrec is very active since 25 years already in the recycling activity. But we tend more and more into the real circular economy, where we not only sell the secondary raw materials, but also take out specific materials for a specific customer or manufacturer. And I'm very proud on our pilot we did and the approval we got from one of the big manufacturers of washing machines to supply them the special material that they are only using in their equipment, and that's cast iron. Basically, this is concrete,
yeah.
And when you talk about waste, this is waste.
You can't do anything with it.
Yeah, if we take it out separately, but then it's for construction work, you can reuse.
Yeah.
And Miele is the only one who uses cast iron.
Okay.
And that part is we take out.
These cast iron parts, they're cheap. And yet it is economically feasible to sell them to Miele?
Yeah, we have some additional work to get them out.
Uh-huh.
But we shorten the supply chain, but we can do it for more or less the same price. And sometimes, in other cases, it's also possible to make it cheaper.
Can I? Oh yeah, that's really heavy.
Yeah.
So that is parts harvesting.
Well, maybe I should clarify material harvesting. Parts harvesting, materials simply, let's say, the plastic, for example. In this case is a very specific material we take out. And parts is really take out the part and leave it as it is. So not shred it and make small pieces, but leave it as it is and supply back. Yeah?
Is that where you see the industry developing?
Yeah, especially for the e-waste. Because first of all, it's the responsibility of the manufacturer who puts a new product on the market to take care of the recycling. And I want to close the loop, and also the manufacturer want to close the loop, because then they take the full responsibility of putting new on the market and get it recycled on a proper way, and also get the materials reused. Because they have in their ambition as well the reuse of material in their end product.
And you can supply that?
We started it. It's, I think, some years to go. But we started, and the manufacturers are really very excited and open about it. I think recycling was 20 years different than today, and it will be in 10 years. And we tend more and more into the supply of raw materials. It's still called recycling, but I think that's a maybe different view on the term, the term recycling. Mm-hmm.